Good evening, everyone. I'm Daniele Rigon, a PhD student of the University of Padua. Today I'm going to talk about a data processing technique in order to estimate the specific heat loss in several non stainless steel specimens for fatigue strength analysis. So the outline of this work are divided in this point, a brief introduction and the motivation of this work. Then I'll present you the experimental method to evaluate this energy parameter, as called specific heat loss per cycle. After that, I show you the data processing technique in order to investigate the energy distribution close to the notch tip using an infrared camera. After that, I show you the energy distribution result and finally the conclusion. So, as it well known, most of the mechanical input energy of a unit of material subjected to cyclic loading is dissipated as heat to the surrounding. Starting from this evidence, Menegatti in 2007 analytically demonstrated and proposed an experimental method in order to evaluate the specific heat loss per cycle during a fatigue test by using a thermocouples fixed at a position of the material for a plain and blunted notch in material or an infrared camera in the case of several notch parts. The method consists in measuring the temperature during the fatigue test. As you know, the temperature of the material increases until you reach a stable value after one third of the total life of the material. And if we suddenly interrupt the fatigue test, we can evaluate the specific heat loss measuring the initial cooling gradient after the test stop by using this relation coming from the first law of the thermodynamics. These parameters are dependent only on the material properties of the material or the specimens. So recently we validate this method also for several notch specimen with notch tip radius equal to 3, 1 and 0.5 millimeters. The material was made on stainless steel with a thickness of 4 millimeters. Fully reversed fatigue tests were carried out by a servo-drying machine, and the temperature field were measured by an infrared camera with a position rate of 200 Hz and a spatial resolution of 20 micrometer per pixel. So the test setup is represented here. It consists of the black painted specimen clamped to the machine, an infrared camera and a digital microscope. Here we see the evolution of the temperature during a fatigue test. As you see, we perform several test stops in order to measure the specific heat loss before a technical crack initiation detected by the digital microscope with a crack length on the order of 10 of millimeters. And here you see a video recording from the infrared camera. You see the pulsating distribution of the temperature due to the thermoelastic effects. And if we interrupt the fatigue test, we see the cooling rate. And measuring the initial cooling gradient, we can obtain the specific heat loss for this test. If we plot the specific heat loss against the number of cycles, we see for the plain material the specimen, the fatigue test results are in good agreement with the scatter band previously calibrated on more than 100 fatigue test results in terms of specific heat loss in the reference here. And if we plot for the several notch specimen the fatigue test result, we see this this method is validated also for this kind of specimens. But what is the specific heat loss distribution ahead of the notch tip? In order to do this, data processing technique were developed in MATLAB by as an input this variable, so the cooling, the video recording of the cooling rate, the spatial resolution of the infrared camera, the load frequency, the acquisition rate, the material density and the specific heat of the material, and the time we assume that the specimen were stopped. So the time is the first peak of the load cell signal within a range of 20% of the amplitude load applied. So moving on the flow chart, from the video recording we can convert this file in a three-dimensional array in MATLAB with dimension m, n, p, with which m, n are the dimension of the single frame and p is the number of frame acquired by the thermal camera, and e, j, k are the index of this three-dimensional array. Another parameter that we have to decide is the interval in which the linear fitting is evaluated for estimating the initial cooling gradient. So at the first iteration was set 0.1 second and keep constant for all the pixels acquired. Doing this for for all the pixels of the frame, we can obtain a matrix which elements are relevant to the slope of the linear fitting, and so multiplying by using the formulation of Professor Meneghetti, we can obtain the energy distribution as a matrix, as you can see here, the plot of this distribution. Here also the distribution of the Q value along the notch bisector. The data are, has to be satisfied two conditions. The first one is the R square of the each element of the DTJ has to be higher than 0.985 for each pixel. And the second condition is a user check of the cooling gradient in some position of the map, automatically generated by the program. Here we see a good estimation of the initial cooling gradient. Here a not good estimation. If this happens, we have to set a new DT variable in order to get the first one. Gradient. So, moving on, we observed a sort of noise in the measurement, and for reduce it, we adopted a filter Gaussian smoothing kernel with the specified standard deviation, which is a MATLAB function already implemented. We adopted a standard deviation ranging from 4 and 6. And you can see the resulting energy distribution. In the map, we also plot the ISO energy level relevant to the 90% of Q0, which Q0 is the value at the notch tip, 80% of Q0, and so on. We also evaluate the region, a circular region centered to the notch tip, in which the energy is higher or equal to the 90% of Q0. So in this region, we can say the energy evaluated is almost constant. The results for different notch tip radius are reported here. For notch tip radius equal to 3 mm, we observe a region higher than those observed for the notch tip radius equal to 0.5 mm. And these are the all the collecting data available up to now. We cannot say a lot about the correlation between this constant energy region on, for example, the knot-tip radius of the amplitude level applied. But we can state that in this region we can measure the energy, and the energy is almost constant. So the conclusion, a fully reversed fatigue test on several knot specimen and a different knot-tip radius were analyzed in order to investigate the its energy distribution higher than the knot-tip. Data analysis procedure has been developed in MATLAB for evaluating the specific heat loss for each pixel of the acquired frame. And the result demonstrates that the specific heat loss is almost constant in a circular region at the notch tip with a radius ranging from 0.5 and 0.8 millimeters and equal to the maximum value at the notch tip. So thank you very much for your attention.